Welcome back to Sarah in the Boot. Today I'm going to talk about where I specifically live in the south of Italy. Like what I said before in my previous video, in my introduction video, I said that I live in the Campania region. And in the Campania region, the capital city is Naples, and I'm about an hour drive from Naples. The town that I live in is called Sant'Agata sui Due Golfi. The name of the town actually kind of tells you where it's located. Sant'Agata, which is Saints Agata, and sui Due Golfi literally translates to in between two gulfs. So you can kind of tell where I'm at. I'm between the Gulf of Naples and the Gulf of Salerno. The Gulf of Salerno is very famous for the Amalfi Coast. And in the Amalfi Coast, there are many famous towns along the sea, including Positano, Ravello, Nerano, and of course, Amalfi. And fun fact, I actually just saw the trailer for Wonder Woman, and in the trailer, I realized, wow, I wonder where they shot this. This looks very familiar. Like, I feel like this is right near me. Some of their filming locations included Ravello in one of their famous villas, Coperta near Salerno, and Pulinuro. I live on top of the mountain in this tiny little town, but it's really beautiful and has a lot of characteristics, so I want to show you around my town and my home. I'm going to show you where I get my coffee in the morning, where I buy a cornetto, a croissant, where I go buy my groceries, where I buy my wine, where do I go if I want to play a game of football or soccer, where do I go to see a beautiful view. So I'm going to show you around, be a little tourist in Sant'Agata, and you get to see everything that I see every day. My cat is literally freaking out. My cat is just chilling right outside my window. He's looking at me like, what the hell are you doing, Sarah? Maddox. Hey, baby. He's like, what the hell are you doing? His name is Maddox. Me and Luigi named him after the captain of Naples' soccer team, or football team, Maddox Hamsik. Forza Napoli, sempre. So yeah, I'm also going to show you around, like, do a bella passeggiata. A bella passeggiata actually means, like, a beautiful walk. Passeggiata itself is just, like, doing a walk. You do a passeggiata with your friends, your significant other, your family. You usually do it on a really nice day when the weather's beautiful, and you literally just walk around town, stop in a bar, get a nice cafe, espresso, or you can even stop at another bar, get a drink, a spritz, and you say hi to everyone you know. Sant'Agata is actually very tiny. So you can walk everywhere, which is great. I love that, especially since I'm like terrified of driving here. It's a whole other thing. Italian drivers, Italian traffic is insane. I'm kind of terrified of that. So I let Luigi drive everywhere. Sant'Agata is really cute. If you ever come to Italy, I definitely recommend to come visit. And let me know if like some of my friends or family or someone that you know is going to Italy, like, oh my god, talk to my friend Sarah. She knows what she's talking about. Kind of. Unfortunately, the only thing that I'm not a big fan of is that we have to drive to the beach. But I mean, come on, it's not like where I'm from, Philadelphia, you know, driving to the beach is like an hour. Here, to drive to the beach is like 15 minutes. And it gets a little, in the winter, it gets a little colder up here. We're so high up and high altitude. It's really cool because you get some amazing views. Welcome to Sant'Agata. So we're looking at Monte San Costanzo right now. And right now I'll be walking up this road further on and we'll go to the monastery. Welcome to Monastero di San Paolo. Alright, we just reached the top of the hill and we're right outside the front of the monastery. If you walk around to the right towards the back, you'll see a beautiful view of Sorrento. And just look at this view. Right down there is the town of Sorrento along the Mediterranean Sea, Gulf of Naples. And right over there is Vesuvius himself. Below Vesuvius is the city of Naples. And to the left, you can also see a bit of Procida and Ischia. This is truly one of the best views of all Sant'Agata. And this sign says in Italian, your salvation gods hug the universe. I mean, just look at this view. It's so beautiful. And now we're gonna head to the center of Sant'Agata because the monastery is actually located on top of this giant hill, which we now have to walk down. Walking down the road. All right, listen carefully. You can hear someone playing the saxophone. Thank you.
is all of Sant'Agata. And the beaches. Scooter. People ride around them all the time. And we head this way to the center.
Stai attenta. Ha avuto tutto inizio in questa stanza. Non perdere di vista neanche l'ombra. E fermati un momento a quel che sembra. A volte tutto quello che abbastanza. Non chiederti se qui qualcosa è persa. Tra quello che non è.
Right here is El Gringo Pub. Right now it's actually closed, but they serve amazing Mexican food and also Italian food. Great place to stop when you're going out at night. El Gringo. And this is located in the center of Sant'Agata.
Hakuna Matata! This is a little store where parents can buy stuff for their kids. And just to the left is the school where the kids of Sant'Agata go to. Right here, we have the restaurant called Lo Stuzzichino. Here, you can grab a nice plate of pasta with frutti di mare, which is pasta with a mix of seafood. Many tourists and locals alike come here during the summer to enjoy the nice weather, sit outside, and eat some amazing Italian food. I definitely recommend this place. And here is the beautiful La Chiesa di Sant'Agata. It's located in the center of town with this beautiful mosaic clock right outside. You can see the Italians just roaming around, talking to their friends, enjoying the nice sunny weather. And right over here is my favorite bar, Roxy Bar. Here you can grab a nice cup of coffee, and we're gonna go in there right after we go inside the church. Here we go. Grazie. Così. It's the most famous restaurant in all of Sant'Agata. Don Afonso 1890 is 3 Michelin stars and an absolute incredible dining experience. Right now, doing construction for the summer though.
And this right here is Bar Orlando. Lando's actually right over there talking to his friends. And they're doing renovations for the summer as well. And outside they have all these chairs. It's really beautiful. Oh, look at this beautiful cat. Oh my gosh. Meow. Oh my God, you're so beautiful. Oh my gosh, come here. Meenie. Oh, and there's the church bell. Rings at every hour, quarter of an hour, and half hour.
So as you can tell, this bar is very cat-friendly. Over here, you can see a mosaic that says "Vedermi per credere," which means "See me to believe." Bar Orlando actually had a cat named Jolly in the 1950s that he taught to smoke cigarettes and jump through his arms. So that's why there's a mosaic of cats smoking cigarettes. And in Jolly's honor, they actually made a statue of him right over there. You can see that he's actually holding a cigarette in his mouth as well. This bar is pretty cool, so definitely come check it out when you come here.
Oh boy went back to Napoli because he missed the scenery, the native dancers and the charming songs. But wait a minute, something's wrong. crazy, do the mambo like crazy. And hey, mambo, don't wanna tarantella. Hey, mambo, no more the mozzarella. Hey, mambo, Italiano, try an enchilada with a fish and bacalhau. Case of Dietrich, get a happy in the feet of when you mambo Italiano. Shake a baby, shake a cause of love when you take me in. Hey, Giorgio, you don't have to go to school. Just make a little beat from Bino. Kids, you're good looking, but you don't know what to cook until you hey, 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 hey. Shake a baby, shake a cause of love when you take me by the pizzeria. That's where I'm gonna be. Don't you tell your mama, mama's gonna tell her papa. There's another.
This shop called Mama is owned by my friend Marika. She has trendy Italian jewelry and clothing that you'll love.
What I would do to take away this fear of being loved, allegiance to the pain. Now I fucked up and I'm missing you. I'll never be like you. I would give in. Anything to change this fickle-minded heart that loves fake shiny things. Now I fucked up and I'm missing you. I'll never be like you. I'm only human, can't you see? I made a mistake. Please just look me in my face. Tell me everything's okay, 'cause I got it. Ooh, I'll never be like you.
Bye.
Somewhere, any place is better. Starting from zero, got nothing to lose. Maybe we'll make something. Me, myself, I got nothing to prove. You got a fast car. I got a plan to get us out of here. I've been working at the convenience store. Managed to save just a little bit of money. Won't have to drive too far. Just cross the border and into the city. You and I can both get jobs. Finally see what it means to be living. You got a fast car. Passing off so we can fly away. We gotta make a decision. Live tonight or die this way.
And this is Route 66. Our friends Mario, Pasquale, and Francesco own this pub. And it's an American bar where you can have burgers and nice draft beer and whatever you want. It's only open at night though. So right now it's not open. But you can kind of tell what it looks like inside. And this is Parco Sportivo Sant'Anna. It's also a pizza place. So this is where you can play or watch a great game of soccer and eat a really good pizza. Now let's go inside.
Until you go, oh, oh.